fisherman in China.
He'll never be anything but a fisherman in China.
But here, he has hope. He can dream of something better.
These families came to America in different and harrowing conditions. This place symbolizes what they all managed to build. They didn't ask what this country could do for them, but what they could do to make this the greatest home of freedom in history.
Tell your children.
They're called the Green Dragons.
These guys are pulling in millions of dollars a year, smuggling people.
Two immovable forces,
either side willing to back down.
What would it take for you to put it all on the line?
Dino!
There's no way both of us walk away, not from that.
What do you want, Sonny?
They're going down. All of them. There's a storm coming, Detective. I don't know of any umbrella that's gonna keep the city dry. We do it our way.
They're watching you.
Why do you bring us here?
It's what this country's built on. The American dream.
Just how many times can Martin Scorsese remake Goodfellas? The film is very fresh in my mind. I actually just watched it last weekend because I was rummaging through the Blu-ray section at Barnes & Noble and came across an anniversary edition. Very cool. It also came with a documentary on the heyday of the gangster film, which I haven't had a chance to watch yet, but the film really holds up and it's really well done. But while I was watching it, I was struck by how similar Goodfellas is to Wolf of Wall Street. It's as if Martin Scorsese decided, hey, that is arguably my most famous feature to date. I'm going to remake it as, you know, with the finance version. I don't think that Wolf of Wall Street turned out as well, because I think that, just really quick, my theory is that there was less of the criminal activities to explore as there was in Goodfellas. So it left Wolf of Wall Street to have to focus almost entirely on Jordan Belfort's personal life and the debauchery, which was included in Goodfellas, but I think in a more sophisticated manner, which didn't revel in it as much, because I think they had other stuff to discuss. So if you're looking for an interesting thing to do, watch those two films back to back or the same weekend for comparison. And then eventually, I think you can add The Revenge of the Green Dragons to that. Now, of course, another film that Martin Scorsese is obviously quite well known for is The Departed. I really like that film quite a bit. I don't think it's as iconic as his work in Goodfellas, but still very well realized. And I think it's very nice that he's backing that filmmaker who made the original Asian film Infernal Affairs that inspired The Departed. Basically, Scorsese remade it here in Hollywood and got quite a lot of mileage out of it. And so it's great that he's helping that original director come here to the States, to Hollywood. Also, you're seeing, again, another interesting dynamic, a new dynamic to Hollywood's, interest, very strong interest in the Asian market. Because I imagine a film like this will play quite well there, in addition to probably playing pretty well here in the United States. So even though it is like Goodfellas, and I find that a little frustrating, because, you know, Casino also has some aspects to that, and Wolf of Wall Street, and I also feel that I would like to see a little more creativity in some of the visuals. The poster for this movie is really cool, and I wish that was reflected a little bit more in the movie, but I'm still very interested. I mean, when you say it, from either being an executive in the boardroom when Scorsese and company are pitching this, to being a moviegoer, seeing the trailer and the poster, the idea of Goodfellas, but in the Asian community, is a very good sell. It's very interesting, and it's the perfect. It says, I can see why Hollywood would fall in love with this, because it's building off of a known commodity that people like, but putting on a new, fresh twist that makes it seem fresh and new. So the other thing I think is interesting here is the casting. There's a bit of stunt casting going on here. You have Kevin Wu from YouTube. And then also Harry Shum Jr., who you might recognize from Glee and the League of Extraordinary Dancers. Interestingly, he's also going to be in the new Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon film, and apparently a large role. Now, with all due respect to Harry Shum Jr., I'm not familiar with Kevin Wu, his work at all, but Harry Shum Jr., from the episodes of Glee that I watched, not the greatest actor. Great dancer, but he couldn't even sing, actually, as well. You'll notice that his character actually conspicuously never really sang. So, I don't know, I mean, maybe his dance moves are going to, you know, be able to transition into martial arts for Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon 2, but here, I don't know, I worry that the film, in an effort to try and make sure that they can get, Asian talent that's recognizable to American audiences in the film, they might have undercut the quality of the acting. We'll see, though. It would be great, though. It would be the best of both worlds if both Kevin Wu and Harry Shum Jr. were phenomenal in the film, and then they brought in people as an audience from their fan bases, and then showed them a whole different side of themselves as actors. So that would be the ideal situation. So I'm curious, what do you think of this? What do you think of Scorsese revisiting Goodfellas yet again? Are you interested in seeing it from the Asian perspective? What do you think of the people who've been cast in this film? And also, do you feel the film needs to push itself any further, or do you think that, this being the Asian Goodfellas is enough? Write your thoughts down below. Thank you so much for tuning into my review, and I think this is definitely a movie that we're going to probably want to keep an eye on. All right, thanks so much for watching. Bye.